its heavens, the beauty of a virtuous wife is the radiance of our home. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
O Lord, my heart is not proud, nor are my eyes haughty. I busy not myself with great things, nor with things too sublime for me.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
Nay, rather I have still and quiet in my soul like a weaned child. Like a weaned child on its mother's lap, so is my soul within me.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
O Israel, hope in the Lord, both now and forever.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace. Alleluia. Give him praise and thanks because his words are efficacious. They touch our lives and they allow us to peer into the mystery of his transformative love. In this Gospel of St. Luke, Jesus journeyed to a city called Nain. And you could imagine our thoughts are right there. With a mother who was a widow that buried her only son. You and I can understand and feel the empathy and also the sorrow of this particular woman. Jesus allows us to peer in not only to this particular situation, but how it's a reflection of his own mother, a widow. Because by that time Joseph had died, and, of course, her son dead, crucified. It peers into a mystery, and it helps us to understand. And Jesus then comes to her and allows them to stop the procession. And he touches the coffin. And the young man sits up and begins to speak. His word is very transformative, because his words are not just letters forming a thought. His word is alive. We always say it's the word that became flesh. So the words and deeds of Jesus are flesh. They're flesh for us, and they allow us to be transformed because of that spoken word. Jesus allows us to understand the sorrow of a mother. And today, as the church celebrates the obligatory memorial of St. Monica, we can understand her sorrow. A mom takes care of her children physically, we know that, emotionally, without a doubt, but also called to take care of her children spiritually, to pray for them. Not for them just to be good people, because that's what God made us to be. He looked upon his creation and he called it good. God has already done that. But a call to respond to that goodness, that's what we really need to pray for. A call to respond to the goodness of God for their own spiritual well-being. And sometimes that's difficult in life, isn't it? I think there's a natural part of us that wants us to take care of our bodies and our mind. But sometimes the soul doesn't get the first cut. It's just postponed. It's put aside as if there's no reason to worry about that. I'll worry about that when I need to worry about it. But don't bother me with all that spiritual stuff now. And yet we're made up of body and soul. And we have to see them as one, not as separate entities. Well, Monica truly understood that and prayed for the conversion of her son Augustine. And for her husband as well. She was a wife and a mother. And her goodness of her prayers of not stopping to pray, never ceasing in prayer, is a good thing. Petitioning our Lord for the good. And the conversion happened with Augustine. The conversion happened on that one day. Tomorrow we celebrate this feast, don't we? But we relish in this moment that Monica had such a love for Augustine, for her son and her husband, that she prayed tirelessly for them, for the good of their soul. And conversion happened to both of them. May you and I pray for others this day in a particular way, maybe for our children and our grandchildren, for their spiritual well-being, that not do they know God, I think most of them do know God. That's not the question here. It's a response to that love. It is diving into the very person of Jesus and being, of course, closely united with him. To hear his word and to participate in the sacrament. May you and I continue to strengthen our faith by God's grace, by responding to him, and by never us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. So that encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us, and win with them the imperishable crown of glory of Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and archangels, and with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew. So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body. mystery of faith, we
proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let the Savior's command be informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The kingdom of heaven is like a merchant who travels in search of fine pearls, and who, on finding one of great price, sold everything and bought it.
Amen.
archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness